So now we'd like to see how we use the chain rule in conjunction with some of the other rules we've learned already, like the product rule and the quotient rule. In the example we're looking at here, we have negative 9 times e to the x sine of x. Now, the negative 9 we can bring out front and sort of ignore, because remember, a constant times any function, the derivative will just have that constant in the front, times whatever the derivative of the rest of it is. But what about the e to the x sine x? How do we find the derivative of that? Well, we need to kind of break it down into its pieces, where we know how to find the derivative of each piece. So how many basic kind of building block functions do we have here? Well, we have an e to the something, we have an x, and we have a sine x. So we should have 3 functions that we know how to take the derivative of. E to the something, x, and sine x. If we have 3 functions, that means we're going to need 2 rules to kind of glue them together. So there should be, you know, kind of some glue there, 2 rules. So which 2 rules are we going to need to use in this problem? Well, we have x multiplied by sine x. So we should be thinking that it is going to make sense to use the product rule. But we have e to the something, where the something there is a complicated function. And so that means we're going to need a chain rule. That's a composition. So those are our 2 rules. But how do we know which ones to do first? Well, the answer here is we need to look at what's the most outside thing. We're going to work from the outside in. So we're going to start with the outsidemost operation. So the outsidemost thing going on in negative 9 e to the x sine x is the multiplying by negative 9. Multiplying by negative 9, like I said, is a constant, and it just comes along out front. So now that we've taken care of that part, if we look at e to the x sine x, the outsidemost thing going on there is the e. E to the something takes care of everything else going on in this equation. So the first thing we need to do is use the chain rule. The chain rule, the composition of e with these other functions, is the outsidemost thing. So how do you take the chain rule of e to the x sine x? The outside function is e to the something. The inside is x sine x. So after our negative 9, we're going to be putting the derivative of e to the something, which is e to that something. So e to the x sine x, since that's our inside function. And then we need to follow that with the derivative of x sine x. Now that derivative is kind of complicated, so for right now I just wrote down that I need to take that derivative. So we have that f prime of x is negative 9 e to the x sine x followed by the derivative of x sine x. But to find the derivative of x sine x, now we need to do the product rule, because it's x times sine of x. So we have the derivative of the first, the derivative of x is 1, times the second unchanged, so that's sine x, plus the first unchanged, so that's x, times the derivative of the second, so that's derivative of sine, which is cosine x. And that whole thing is the derivative of e to the x sine x times negative 9. That was kind of complicated, so let's try one more example just to make sure that the idea of working from the outside in, starting with the outsidemost thing, is clear to you. So in this example, we're looking at sine of 5x divided by e to the tangent of x plus 17x. The outsidemost thing in this problem is the division sign. So f prime of x is going to be the derivative of the top And I'm just going to write it a note to myself right now that I need to take this derivative. I'm not going to try to do it right now. Times the bottom minus the top times the derivative of the bottom. So again, I'm going to make just a note to myself that I need to take that derivative. All divided by the bottom squared. Alright, so what do we have here? We have two derivatives that we still need to take. Once we figure out these two derivatives and stick them in these two spots, we'll be done with our problem. So, we have f prime of x. Now we need to take the derivative of sine of 5x right here. So here we're going to need a chain rule. The outside function is going to be sine. The inside function is going to be 5x. So I'm going to take the derivative of the outside function. So the derivative of sine is cosine. And then I'm going to keep the inside function unchanged. Then I'm going to multiply by the derivative of the inside function. The inside function here is 5x, so its derivative is 5. So that's the chain rule inside a quotient rule. Now we have to put the rest of the quotient rule here. So we have to put the e to the tangent of x plus 17x, got to write pretty small, minus sine of 5x. And now we need to take the second derivative here, e to the tangent of x plus 17x. What's the outsidemost thing happening in e to the tangent of x plus 17x? You might be thinking it's the e, but actually the outsidemost thing here is going to be this plus sign. This plus sign tells us we can do e to the tangent of x and 17x as two separate problems. So let's start with the first one, e to the tangent of x. E to the tangent of x is going to be another chain rule. It's a composition of functions. The outside function is the e to the something. The inside function is tangent. So the derivative of e to the something is e to that something. And then we need to follow that with the derivative of that something. So the derivative of tangent is secant squared of x. Now, we've taken the derivative of e to the tangent of x using the chain rule. Now, that plus sign says we can take this derivative separately from the derivative of 17x. The derivative of 17x is 17. But here's something really important. Because of this plus sign, we now have to put this derivative we just took in parentheses. And in general, it's a good idea to just always do that to keep your answers nice and clean. So it's easy for an grader to see each piece of the quotient rule or any other problem that you're working on. So now that we've done the derivative of sine of 5x, we've copied all this stuff in the middle, and we've done the derivative of e to the tangent of x plus 17x, we finish the quotient rule by dividing by e to the tangent of x plus 17x squared. And that will be our final answer. When doing these big long derivative problems, we absolutely do not want you to simplify. Please leave your answer like this.